Good morning, ma'am. This is Ajay Sam from team number 5. Today we are here to give a small presentation on Child Labour and Women Employ Act. Our team consists of 5 members: Hari, Vishnu, Rohit, Shajita, and myself, Ajay Sam. First, let's look into Child Labour, followed by Women Employ Act. We'll start with a small introduction on Child Labour. Child labor refers to the employment of children in any work that deprives them from their childhood, interferes with their ability to attend regular school, and that is mentally, physically, or morally dangerous and harmful. Poverty or lack of good schools and growth of informal economy are considered as the important causes of child labor in all places. These are some of the examples of the work which is done by children and is harmful. Here the children are working with heavy machines, metals, harvesting, stitching, polishing, and the most dangerous of these all are they are preparing tobacco leaves, which is very harmful for their leaves. Where does child labor occur and how? Child labor mainly occurs due to poverty. Here, Asia has got 60% of the child labor, where Africa has 23% and South America with 8%. Regrets. Regrets are the most painful thing, and that is mostly faced by child laborers, where they work and do things like toys or stitching balls for their daily lives, while the other kids buy it to enjoy their childhood. From here, Shajita will be taking over the presentation.
Good morning, ma'am. This is Shajita from CSE department, and our topic is about child labor. We all know that child labor is a social issue which is almost all over the world. And going to work at the young age affects the life of the children. When a child is forced to work, they do not get enough time to educate themselves. And one of the main reasons of child labor is poverty. And the parents who are financially poor send their children to work. Over 2 million child laborers are working for their family debts instead of studying in school. And the child labor is a work which is harmful to the children, as it is dangerous to physical and the mental health of a children. Whereas child employment is that work with their ability to go to school, which can affect their income earning potential as adult. And the hazardous labor, nature or the circumstance in which it is carried out. For example, harm the health, safety or moral of the children. Worst forms of child labors are enslaved, and the children are separated from their families, exposed to serious hazards and illness. And the child labor statistics. All over the world, there are 215 million children in child labor. In these, 115 million of these children are in hazardous work. And the causes of child labor are primary causes, cultural causes, and macroeconomic causes. Macroeconomic causes are family factors such as unemployment, large families, poverty, and lack of parenting.
Hello, ma'am. This is Hari. My topic is about how the culture impact in the in increasing the child labors. In certain cultures, beliefs have a rational child labor, and there are encouraged it. In some views, that work is good for the character building and skill development. In many cultures, the culture traditions is that children should follow the parents' route in early, so that they are becoming child laborers in early age. In many cultures, the girls are less valued. They don't provide education for girls. This is the reason for the girls pushed into the child labors. Macroeconomic cause. The major cause of increasing child labor is demand and supply side, and poverty and population and illiteracy and unavailability of good schools. Because of macroeconomic cause, huge child labors increased in India, Pakistan and Indonesia, Thailand and Philippines. The parents getting low wages, and their annual income is very low. So that is the main reason of increasing the child labors. Worst forms of child labors. Many children facing worse situations like sale and trafficking. They offering a child for prostitution, and some use it for production of pornography. Children are used for illegal activities like selling drugs and terror activities and criminal activities. And the conclusion is, the problem of child labor continues to pose a challenge before the nation. Government taking various proactive measures to control these problems. It is a social economic problem. The main reason for the problem is poverty and illiteracy. Every individual to control this, every individual to take the responsibility. The child labor can be controlled if the government takes, if the government works effectively with the support of public.
Hello ma'am, I'm B. Nagarohit from CSC5C. This topic is based on the Women Employment Act, in which we discuss about the various rights of women and the acts implemented by the government for the welfare of women. And these are some various rights of the women. The first one is Maternity Benefit Act, and the second one is Sexual Harassment Act at the workplace, and the third one is Factories Act and the Equal Remuneration Act, and this last one is Shops and Establishments Act. Yeah, and now this is pregnancy discrimination. This last says that it is pregnancy discrimination to treat a woman unfavorably because of her pregnancy or pregnancy related illness. Examples of pregnancy discrimination: selection of redundancy because of your pregnancy or pregnancy related illness, refusing to extend your contract during or after a probation period, dismissal because of pregnancy or non-renewal of a fixed term contract, reduction in pay or hours, pressure to resign, and failure to remove risk at work and take action to protect your health and safety during pregnancy. To show pregnancy or maternity discrimination, you don't have to compare yourself to a man or a woman who is not pregnant, but you need to show that the treatment was because of your pregnancy or absence on maternity leave. All employees, casual workers, agencies and contractors are protected against pregnancy and maternity discrimination from day one of your employment. And the next one is Sexual Harassment Act. Sexual Harassment Act is in line with the Supreme Court definition in the Visakha judgment and includes any unwelcome sexually determined behavior. They are physical contact and advances, demand or request for sexual favors or sexual colored remarks, or any unwelcome physical, verbal or non-verbal conduct of sexual nature. And now, workplace discrimination. Discrimination in the workplace is based on certain prejudices and occurs when an employee is treated unfavorably because of gender, sexuality, race, religion, pregnancy and maternity or disability. If you treat someone differently because they possess different characteristics to other members of staff, you could be acting unlawfully. Different discrimination when someone is treated less favorably than other employees. For example, the employees has the qualifications to do the job, but you turn them down because you think they might want to start a family soon. Direct discrimination can also occur when you pay someone less than other employees for no good reason. Discrimination or unfairly reject a request for flexible working from a new parent.
Hi ma'am, this is Vishnuvardhan from CSC. I'm now going to tell about the age discrimination. This is when you are treated differently because of your age. One of the situations that are covered by the Equality Act. The Equality has some exceptions. For example, students are not protected from age discrimination at school. The treatment could be one of the actions or a result of a rule or policy based on age. Yes, there are some special enactments or provisions for women. The Plantation Act, founded in 1951, the Mines Act at 1952, the Factories Act at 1948, the Payment of Gratuity Act at 1972, the Employees State Insurance Act 1948, the Work Woman Compensation Act 1923. Like this, there are some specialized activities for women. I'm now going to tell about sexual harassment at workplace. India has its Me Too movement. Here is a look at the laws of that are in place to make our workplace safe for women. What amounts to sexual harassment at the workplace? Unwelcome or sexually determined behavior, whether directly or by implications. Physical contact or a demand for sexual favors, sexual colored remarks or showing pornography. And what happens if you violate this? If you inappropriately touch a woman, you'll get up to 1 to 5 years of jail and fine up to 10,000 under Criminal Act. And using words like gestures to outrage a woman's modesty, you'll get up to 3 years jail and fine under Criminal Act 2030. And the outside of the work office can also be the workplace. Apart from office, if any place visited by an employee during the course of employment, including transportation provided by employer for the visit, it covered under the Act. If harassment takes place during a lunch meeting address, it will also be covered. Women must get wages because every person who works must be paid for her work. A person must be paid at least a minimum wages, which is fixed by the government under the Minimum Wages Act 95. Every woman must be paid the same wage as a man for the same kind of work. Women also should be treated equally. And that's it. Thank you, ma'am.